Welcome back to Let Us Learn to Lead video series on free open source software designed by M. Srinivasan Training Associate Mathematics, Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai. Self-learning contents in video form on GeoGebra, a dynamic mathematics software, is presented at this video series. To view the contents, you may join Google Classroom by using the class code 73AUMBO. In this video, you will learn designing a worksheet to visualize arithmetic progression. For preparing this video lecture, I used Windows 10 operating system, a licensed version, GeoGebra 5.0, a free open source software, and free open source screen recorder software. Let us start. Let me show you what type of worksheet we will be showing to the children. We'll tell them that what is arithmetic progression. It is a sequence in order in which the difference of any two consecutive numbers is a constant value. That constant value is called the common difference. And here, I am having a worksheet where I can have a new arithmetic progression. I can show the arithmetic progression. I can ask them to find the nth term and sum up to n terms. For example, let me give you first element as 10, the common difference as 5, and I want the 20 terms. Okay, this I have to simply enter. Now if you want to hide n also, you can hide, there is no problem. Okay. Now the arithmetic progression, the child will be calculating it, T20 and S20 he will calculate. Step number one, you can ask them to show the AP. The AP will be shown. And if you click this show steps, the steps which is being used to find the nth term and find the sum of the nth term will be shown to the children. Therefore, once again, if you click this new arithmetic progression, you can now change it. For example, you can change it into minus 2. Okay. Then you can ask the children to write the arithmetic progression. This is the arithmetic progression. And you can ask them to show the steps and so on. Okay. Therefore, yes, there is a single worksheet where a child can visualize the arithmetic progression totally, all the terms from the first term to the nth term. Then you can also understand that how to find the nth term, how to find sum up to n terms. It's a highly interesting worksheet. Let us try to design this dynamic worksheet from scratch. For that, okay, let us take a dynamic GeoGebra Classic 5 worksheet. And I have taken the graphic view. In the graphic view, I am removing this axis and the grid. Let me start with giving a heading, arithmetic progression. We have to explain to the children that what is arithmetic progression. We can explain it like this by any definition. A very simple definition I have taken. Okay, now for that arithmetic progression, we need A, D and N. Therefore, let us try to have sliders for that. Slider number 1 is for A. Let us have it from minus 25 to 25, till left to you. I am leaving the increment as it is. The increment will be 0.1 if you are not fixing it. Okay. Let us fix it somewhere in 10. Okay. Anyway, we will convert it. No problem. Then we will go to the next slider. We will call it as small d, which we know that this is the common difference, 25 to 25. An increment, I am leaving it as it is. Okay. D also I got. I will go for the third one, again input, slider. I will take it as an integer because this is going to tell the number of terms. I will have 1 to 30 because if it go beyond 1 to 30, it may go outside this screen. But I will have only 30, you can have it as 50 also, no issue. Now, by moving it, it will be very difficult. Therefore, we will convert them into input boxes. The first input box is first term is equal to small a is equal to. Therefore, the linked object should be small a. Is it okay? Then right click, go to the object properties. In the style, make it into 3 and enter. Then don't fix the object so that you can move it. Sorry. Again, go to the next input box. Here you write common difference is equal to small d is equal to. Link d with that. Is it okay? Again, right click, go to the object properties, make it as 3, then close. Then make it as fix the object, remove it, put it over here. Again, we have to go for one more input box, that is number of terms is equal to small n is equal to link object n. Okay, now we are converting the sliders into input box for our convenience. Even for the children also, it will be highly interesting and easy for them to enter the numbers instead of doing the sliders. The sliders, if I move it, you see it is changing. When I move it, it is changing. When I move it, it is changing. Okay, I think the linking is done. Show the object, and show the object. First term I will put it here, common difference I will put it here, and number of terms, sorry. Number of term I will put it here. Okay, first term I will take it as 10, just for practice. This I will make it as 5. I will make it as 15. But just for us to have it. Okay, now this arithmetic progression, we will try to get the nth term. What is the formula for Tn? Tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. A plus n minus 1 into d. I think I have used the same techniques over here. Suppose if I take it this as 2, for example, there are only 2 terms. You see, first term is 10, next term is 15. Therefore, when I take 3 terms, see, automatically it is becoming as 5, 10, 15, the third term will be 20. Okay, I think it is working. But there won't be any problem. Okay, I will just make it as 10. Okay, now I want to get the summation also. What is the formula for summation? Capital S is equal to n by 2, therefore n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 outside d. Okay, n by 2 into 2a plus 1 into n minus 2. Okay, suppose if you are having only 2 terms. Okay, now you know that the answer for it, 10 plus 15 is equal to 25. If there are 3 terms, 10 plus 15, 10 plus 15 plus 20. Therefore, the answer is 45. Okay, well, I think it is working. Therefore, there won't be any problem. Now, what we have to do is we have to now generate the arithmetic progression. Or what we'll do is we'll have the text here. We'll have a text. In that text, we will type the arithmetic, A-R-I-T-H-M-E-T-I-C, P-R-O-G-R-E-S-S-I-O-N, is. You see, we are going to show the children that arithmetic progression being generated. Anyway, the children will be generating. For example, if you are asking them 10, 5 and 15, then they have to write 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, then up to 30, then they have to add 30 plus, 25 plus, 20 plus, 15 plus, 10. Therefore, the answer is 100, like that, okay. Now, the GeoGebra is giving you a direct way of generating the arithmetic sequence. S-E-Q-U-E-N-C-E. You type it. The third one you take, which is the start value, it is A. Okay. Then tab, which is the end value, it is Tn. Sorry, small tn. Then only it will change it into blue color. What is the increment? The increment is D. That's all. Very simple. Therefore, A, nth term and the increment. Okay, now you see, you got it. You got it now? Now you see, you got it. Okay, anyway, now this to be displayed over here. Okay, therefore, I will go for this object, go to L1. That is displayed. Okay, now all of you tell me, sir, what will happen if I make it as 10 and do it? You see, 10 terms you got. Suppose if I have 30 terms, I think this we have to little bit change it and then put it and then put it over here. That is why I told you, na? If it go beyond 30, it will go outside your screen. Therefore, you should be a little bit careful. Okay. Now, suppose if you change this into 2, you see automatically it changes. Therefore, this arithmetic progression is automatically generated by this GeoGebra. Now, what you can do? You can now go on tell the children about how it being done. Therefore, you can go for the text. Therefore, first term, you can go on tell the children that what is actually first term, A is equal to, then from the object, you can take A. You can display it to the children. Then again, go to the ABC. To the children, you display that what is the common difference. Is equal to small d is equal to from the object u d and then put it. Okay, then again ABC number of terms is equal to small n is equal to from the object you select n. Okay, now you can tell the children that nth term. Therefore, here in the latex formula you can use, because that will be better. Here n, small n, then term, nth term, th. Okay, then latex formula space term is equal to, you can tell the formula to the children, it is a plus n minus 1 into d. Is it okay? So the child can understand that, okay, this is the formula for it. Now I think you can show to the children that what will be the nth term. It is latex formula. Okay, latex formula, you can go for this subscript is equal to, here it is a tn, therefore capital T. In place of this, you go and have the object n. Okay, it is now, you see, 330 is being displayed. What is a? Therefore, a plus n minus 1, therefore within the bracket, n, therefore small n, minus 1 into d, therefore d. You see, whenever you are doing any changes, automatically it will get changed. Okay, now again go to the ABC. Now you can display the answer. You can show the calculations also. Otherwise, you can directly display the answer. Therefore, Tn, capital T of n is equal to, from this object, it is Tn. I think it will be at the last Tn. Okay, finish. Okay, now you can go on changing it. Suppose you change it into 25. You see, automatically you get that at 83. Suppose you change it into, I want only 25 terms. So the answer is 73. Similarly, you can show it to the children that summation. You can tell them the formula, latex formula, Sn, okay, is equal to, here, this to be converted into capital S. You see, instead of making use of slash and all, if you use it automatically, the original formula structure will come to the children. Therefore, n by 2, therefore this is n and this is 2 multiplied by within the bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. I think highly interesting. You can show it to the children. Okay, now this Sn already you have calculated, that can be shown to the children here. Therefore, capital Sn, latex formula you can go for, latex formula, here the subscript formula, here you type capital S, here you type N, is equal to, already we have calculated it, it is capital S. Is it okay? You can show it also, how that N is what, 2A is what, as I did here. Okay, now you see you can change it now, suppose your D is equal to 3, it totally changes. You can have it in the negative side also, therefore minus 3 for example, you see, everything changes, automatic. Therefore, you see, here, you can have control over it, the terms, and you can have a input checkbox for this. For this checkbox, you can have, and if you want to show it, you can show it in a step-by-step fashion. Suppose otherwise, what you can do is, you can go to this navigation bar. In the navigation bar, one step after the other step, you can show it to the children. You see, you can ask them that, now tell me what is the arithmetic progression. Now I think you can ask a question to it also, if you want to ask a question, therefore AB text, therefore you can ask the question, find, in the latex formula you can go, and you can have a space, and you can ask them to find TN, and, okay, first I will type TN, okay, TN, what is N here, every problem that n should change, na, therefore Tn, okay, then space and space Sn. Therefore, once again, go for this subscript capital S, and here don't type n, you take it from the object. Okay, now you see this is the question you are asking to the children. Okay, suppose if you are making it into 15, you see automatically it changes. You are asking what is T15 and S15. Okay, like that, this worksheet can be used for the children to visualize the arithmetic progression, and they can check their calculations also. For it is highly useful to the teachers also, so that in the class, by changing the first term, by changing the common difference and changing the number of terms, you can show the children that how the arithmetic progression is generated and how the formula is used to calculate the nth term and the sum up to n term. Thank you. Let us learn to lead.